गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, कैसे हो सब लोग? रिवाइज हुआ सब? या सुबह के सोने के मूड में हो? राइट, तो फ्रेंड्स वी आर लर्न राइट अप टू 7th पेज आई थिंक सो, और उसमें हमने बहुत सारी चीज़ें देखी है। मेनली रीडिंग है टू इंक्रीज अवर नॉलेज एंड ऑल, राइट? कैसे मर्चेंट कम्युनिटी को कैसे कम्युनिटी को ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंस दिया गया, दैट वी हैव लर्न, राइट? कौन से सेंटर से बिजनेसेस, व्हाट द इंपोर्ट एंड एक्सपोर्ट वी आर डूइंग, ये सब हमने देखा। नाउ फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द पोजीशन ऑफ इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट इन वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमी। हमारा भाग कितना है और हम कैसे कर रहे हैं, है ना? द परफॉर्मेंस प्लेज द वाइटल रोल। हम कितना जीते उसे इम्पोर्टेंट नहीं, हम कैसे काम कर रहे हैं दैट इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट। बिटवीन द फर्स्ट एंड द 7th सेंचुरी India is estimated to have the largest economy of the ancient and the medieval period, right? Yes friends, the topic we are going to discuss is position of Indian subcontinent. Aur usme humne abhi kya padha? Between the 1st and the 7th centuries, India is estimated to have the लार्जेस्ट इकोनॉमी ऑफ द एंशियंट एंड द मिडिवल पीरियड। देखो कितनी ताकत हमने किया था इंडस्ट्री में। सो व्हाट दे वांट टू से, बिटवीन द फर्स्ट एंड द 7th सेंचुरी इंडिया इज एस्टिमेटेड टू हैव द लार्जेस्ट इकोनॉमी ऑफ द एंशियंट एंड द मिडिवल पीरियड, कंट्रोलिंग अबाउट 1/3 एंड 1/4 ऑफ वर्ल्ड वेल्थ टाइम। Right, it's a great achievement at that time, right? So what they want to say, between the 1st and the 7th century, India is estimated to have become the world largest economy in ancient and the medieval period, controlling about 1/3 and 1/4 of the world wealth. That's why when the Vasco da Gama discovered America and he said that I have discovered India, that means at that time our India was very famous. In coming years, pray to the God that may again we become the largest economy of the whole world. The country was often referred as Swarna Bhumi, that is gold, Swarna Bhumi, and Swarna Deep in the writing of many travelers such as Megasthenes, Phasian, Zunsang, Alberoni, IBM Batuta, Frenchman Francis and other, they repeatedly referred to the prosperity of the country. Just see that. The country was often named as Swarna Bhumi. Country was termed as Swarna Bhumi and Swarna Deep area. Swarna Bhumi, gold, right? Gold land, and Swarna Deep, gold port. Right, pre-colonial period in India history, pre-colonial matlab Britishers aane se pehle, the pre-colonial period in India, pre-colonial period in Indian history was an age of prosperity. Pre-colonial period was the age of prosperity in Indian economy and made the Europeans embark great voyages of discovery. Right, the pre-colonial period was very, very important, very, very prosperous, and made the European people, European means UK, France and other country, great voyages of discovery. They started to discover the new places, and in that they have discovered India also. Initially they came to plunder, but soon realized the reward of trade in exchange of gold and silver. Initially they came to plunder, pehle to galtiya ki unhone, but soon they have realized the trade is to be done in exchange of gold and silver. Despite the growing commercial sector, it is evident that the 18th century, 1800 sadi mein, India was far behind Western Europe in technology, innovation and idea. यहाँ पे हमारा problem शुरू हुआ. It was evident that the 18th century India was, हमने सब कुछ किया, हमारे पास सब कुछ था, but we are not in technology, innovations and ideas. हम बहुत पीछे रह गए थे. It is evident that the 18th century India was far behind Western Europe. Far behind Western Europe in technology ho, innovations ho, ya new ideas. With the increasing control of the East India Company causing lack of freedom. Hamari azadi chhin rahi thi dheere dheere. And no occurrence of agriculture. Agriculture badh nahi raha tha. And scientific revolution. Limited reach of education. Education hum piche reh rahe the. Limited reach education to the masses. Population growth. Har ghar mein 10-12 bachche hote the wo time pe. And preference to machine over the manual skill made India a country which was prosperous but with the people who were poor. हम आगे तो बढ़ रहे थे लेकिन हमारे देश के लोग गरीब होते जा रहे थे. सो व्हाट दे वांट टू से इन द प्री कॉलोनियल पीरियड. ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी आने से पहले द प्री कॉलोनियल पीरियड इन इंडिया वाज एन एज ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी. एज ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी फॉर द इंडियन इकोनॉमी. दैट्स व्हाई यूरोपियन एम्बार ग्रेट वॉयेजेस ऑफ डिस्कवरी. Initially, they came to plunder, but soon realized the importance of gold and silver. Despite the growing commercial sector, it was evident that 18th century India was far behind the European countries in terms of technology, innovations, and ideas. With the increasing control of the East India Company, that causes a lot of freedom and non-occurrence of agriculture and scientific revolution. Agriculture revolution bhi nahi ho raha tha, kuch naya nahi seekh rahe the, aur scientific revolution bhi nahi ho raha tha. Limited reach of education to the masses. Education kam ho rahe the apne bachcho ke saath. Population growth ho raha tha. Preference of machine over the manual skill made India a country which was prosperous, but the people which were poor. Right. Yes. So even we are in the prosperous, the people were very poor. Now the topic is that how the Britishers, right, exploited us. The British Empire began to take roots in India. British Empire started to take root in India in the mid 18th century. 1850 se shuru hua unka kaam. The East India Company used revenue generated by the province under its rule for purchasing India raw material. Pehle to who has come 100 years by the East India Company and 100 years by the Britishers. Aise unhone 200 saal hamare pe raj kiya. The East India Company used revenue. Kya likha gaya hai? The East India Company used revenues generated by the provinces under its rule for purchasing Indian raw material, spices and goods. Here, the continuous inflow of bullion that used to come on account of foreign trade stopped. यानी जो gold and silver अपने देश में आ रहे थे, हम जब export कर रहे थे, हम कैसे ले रहे थे पैसे gold and silver में, वो बंद हो गए. बहुत तकलीफ होने लगा ना. दिस चेंज द कंडीशन ऑफ द इंडियन इकोनॉमी फ्रॉम बीइंग एन एक्सपोर्टर ऑफ द प्रोसेस गुड्स टू द एक्सपोर्टर ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल. हुआ क्या, उल्टा हो गया. हम पहले एक्सपोर्ट करते थे सामान, फिनिश्ड प्रोडक्ट्स, नाउ वी आर एक्सपोर्टिंग रॉ मटेरियल. और वहां से प्रोसेस होके हमारे पास आता था, तो हम इम्पोर्ट कर रहे थे, हम मैन्युफैक्चर गुड्स सब खरीद रहे थे, तो हमारे बहुत प्रॉब्लम बढ़ने लगा, हमको हमारे पैसे वहां जाने लगे. Right, what they want to say, it's clear, I think so. Again, one more time, dekho kya likha hai. The East India Company used revenue generated by the provisions. क्या लिखा है? East India Company used revenue generated by the provisions under its rule for purchasing Indian raw material, spices and goods. So here the continuous inflow of bullion that used to come on account of foreign trade stop. This changed the condition of the Indian economy from being an exporter of the processed goods to the exporter of the raw material and the buyer of manufactured goods. Now comes the topic, India began to re-industrialize. Ab ye kya hota hai? After independence, right, वापस हम अपना देश को आगे बढ़ाने लगे. कैसे? After independence, the process of rebuilding the economy started and India first went to the centralized planning. देखो क्या लिखा है, बहुत सिंपल है. We have get the independence near about 1950. और उसके बाद हमें पूरा नीचे से ऊपर तक आगे बढ़ना था. सो आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस द प्रोसेस ऑफ रीबिल्डिंग द इकोनॉमी स्टार्टेड एंड इंडिया वेंट फॉर सेंट्रलाइज्ड प्लानिंग. द फर्स्ट फाइव ईयर प्लान वॉज इम्प्लीमेंटेड इन 1952. Due importance was given to, सबसे ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंस किसको दिया गया? Due importance was given to the establishment of modern industries, modern technology, scientific institute, space and nuclear program. Despite these efforts, the Indian economy could not develop at a rapid pace. क्योंकि हमारा स्पीड कम रह गया था, क्योंकि पूरा नीचे से बनाना था. ग्रोथ ऑफ पॉपुलेशन था, एग्रीकल्चर में रेवोल्यूशन नहीं था, तो बहुत सारे प्रॉब्लम्स आने लगे. तो क्या लिखा कहना चाहते हैं? आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस द प्रोसेस ऑफ रीबिल्डिंग ऑफ इकोनॉमी स्टार्टेड एंड इंडिया वेंट टू सेंट्रलाइज्ड प्लानिंग. द फर्स्ट फाइव ईयर प्लान वॉज इम्प्लीमेंटेड इन 1952. Due importance was given to the, किस किस को दिया था? Establishment of, I will just highlight for you, establishment of modern industries, modern technology, scientific institute, space and nuclear program. Despite this effort, the Indian economy could not develop in a rapid pace. Kyun? Lack of capital formation, paise lagane mushkil lag rahe the. Rise in population, population badh raha tha. Huge expenditure on defense. Right, and inadequate infrastructure. Hamare paas proper availability of land, proper availability of electricity, ye sab available nahi tha. That was the major reason. As a result, India relied heavily on borrowings. Hame udhar lena pada from foreign sources, and finally agreed to economic liberalization in 1991. Mein humne kya kiya? पूरी इकोनॉमी को हमने ओपन कर दिया. द इंडियन इकोनॉमी इज वन ऑफ द फास्ट ग्रोइंग इकोनॉमी इन द वर्ल्ड टुडे. आज सबसे ज्यादा डेवलपमेंट अपने पास है. द इंडियन इकोनॉमी इज वन ऑफ द फास्ट ग्रोइंग इकोनॉमी इन द वर्ल्ड टुडे एंड प्रिफर्ड अस FDI, फॉरिन डायरेक्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट डेस्टिनेशन. राइजिंग इनकम, आज लोगों के इनकम बढ़ने लगे. Saving, investment, opportunities, increased domestic consumption. Consumption badhega tabhi to sab kuch hoga. And younger population, aaj ka sabse plus point India ka kya hai? Hamare paas jo population hai, jo youth hai, wo age gap mein 18 to 40 ke age mein aata hai. Ensures the growth for decades to come. The high growth sector have been identified, which were likely to grow at a rapid pace world over, and the reason initiative of government of India such as abhi maine bola make in India, skill India, digital India and roll out the foreign trade policy 1520 is expected to help the economy in terms of export and import and trade balance. Right, तो क्या क्या लिखा है देखो. इंडिया बिगेन टू री इंडस्ट्रियलाइज आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस द प्रोसेस ऑफ रीबिल्डिंग द इकोनॉमी स्टार्टेड एंड इंडिया वेंट फॉर सेंट्रलाइज्ड प्लानिंग द फर्स्ट 5-year प्लान वॉज इम्प्लीमेंटेड इन 1952. Due importance was given to the establishment of modern industries, modern technology and scientific institute, space and nuclear program. Despite these efforts, sab kuch karne ke baad bhi, the Indian economy could not get a rapid pace. Kya reason tha? Lack of capital formation, rise in population, huge expenditure on defense and inadequate infrastructure were the major reason. As a result, India has too heavily borrowed from the foreign country and that's why we have agreed to economic liberalization in 1991. Now the Indian economy is one of the fastest growing economy in the whole world and today is the foreign direct investment perfect destination. Rising income, saving, investment opportunities has been increased, right? And younger population ensures growth for decades to come. The high growth sector has been identified, which are likely to grow at a rapid pace world over. And the recent initiative of the government of India, like Made in India, Skill India, Digital India, rollout of the foreign trade policy, is expected to help the economy in terms of export and import and trade balance. Clear? So, now we are moving to section 2. So, we have completed, friends, section 1 regarding the ancient modern ancient economy. We have revised it, we have learned a lot of things. Right, now we are going to learn in section 2, nature and concept of business. I think we can start from the next period, this topic. Let's read this one. Indian entrepreneurs began to set up their own modern textile mills after 1850. And gradually began to recapture the domestic market. In 1896, Indian mills supplied 8% of total clothes consumed in India, 20% in 1930, and 62% in 1936, and 76% in 1945. So it's a great achievement. Thus, during 1913 to 1938, India's manufacturing output grew 5.6% during per year, which was above the world average of 3.3%. The British government finally provided tariff protection from 1920, which helps industries to expand and diversify. By the time of independence in 1947, Indian entrepreneurs were strong enough and in a position to buy the businesses of departing British. Industry shares in India's GDP had doubled from 3.18% in 1913 to 7.5% in 1947. And the share of manufacturers in export rose from 22.4% to 30% for the years 1913 and 1947 respectively. Right, so it was a great achievement at that time also that we have fought a battle also, as well as we have started with the economy. Now we are experiencing a very great boom in our Indian economy. But due to some this temporary situation of COVID, little bit downfall is there. But 100% within a year, we come across all the, and our economy will boom like anything. Because now the people are, now the lot of countries are not interested in investing in China. They are interested in India now. So India will become a hub destination for manufacturing activities and service activities. So friends, we have done the topic related to ancient businesses, indigenous banking, right? How to set up the sector, position of Indian economy from 1st to 1891, what are the trade sectors, what are the areas, all everything has covered. So revise it perfectly, revise it 100% perfectly, then only you will get into it. Thank you friends. In the next period, we are going to see the modern concept of business, and that is very important, right? So thank you, take care.